How's it? Paul Auger here from Osh.co.za today. Today we are going to be installing Untangle on Microsoft's Hyper-V. First, a little background. We have tested and deployed many, many firewalls and UTM solutions at clients over the years, such as pfSense, IPCOP, FortiGate, and the original granddaddy of them all, ISIS Server, which you might know as Microsoft Forefront Threat Management Gateway. But we've now settled on using Untangle for all of our clients because of the simplicity, the cost, the resource usage, effectiveness, and flexibility of the Untangle Next Generation Firewall. For the home lab, it only costs $50 a year, and for larger companies and corporates, it works on a sliding scale that allows you to pay for what you want to be protected. You can also choose what modules you want to have included, like the SSL inspector, a directory connector for active directory, a WAN balancer, and WAN failover. However, if you want the full functionality of the software, you can buy a complete version. Also, if you are a non-profit company, a private or government school, there are also special prices and deals for you. In terms of flexibility, you can deploy Untangle in a number of different environments and ways, from 32-bit and 64-bit as a virtual appliance on Hyper-V using an ISO, and VMware using an OVA. You can deploy it on AWS, Amazon, and Azure, Microsoft. Or even you can do it on a bare metal server. So why would you want to install Untangle on Hyper-V? Well, instead of paying for VMware licenses, most Windows servers can actually handle Hyper-V without a problem. I've set up Untangle on everything from Windows 10 for a very small client, Windows Server 2008, 2012, 2016, and obviously the latest version of Server 2019. If at some later stage you would like to move this server onto other hardware, having a virtual server makes a great deal of sense. The setup is quite simple, but there are a couple of configuration issues that you might be, that you need to be aware of. When you set up Untangle, using virtual switches for the WAN, and if you follow this tutorial, it should make the process quite simple. So now we're going to set up Untangle. On the Hyper-V, let's start with the virtual switches. So let's open up Hyper-V first. Let's try and spell correctly, Hyper-V. Okay, Untangle needs two network cards. So on the Hyper-V, we're going to set up those two network cards. So I'm going to go into the virtual switch manager, and you see it comes currently with a new virtual default switch here. So we're going to go new virtual switch, and we're going to say create virtual switch. We're going to call the two virtual switches, one which is going to be Untangle LAN, and one's going to be Untangle WAN. This way, you can set up exactly the same way as me, and you can see what's happening. So the first one I'm going to do is I've got this USB network controller here. So I'm going to say this is going to be Untangle WAN. So that's going to be connected straight into my router. I'm then going to take away that tick. So we're not going to allow the base operating system to interact with this network card. I'm then going to say new network, virtual network switch again, create, and this one is going to be called Untangle LAN. This one is going to be a different network card, and there's my other network card. So I'm now going to push OK, and those are going to be there. So just wait for it to apply. Okay. So under the virtual switch manager, the LAN is the one that's going to connect to the rest of your network, and the WAN is going to have a cable straight from this server through to your router. We're now going to create, we're going to say new and virtual machine, push next past this, and we're going to call this virtual machine Untangle. So you can either change where you want the virtual machine to be stored, or you can sort of like you can leave it in the default place. So let's push next. We're going to use generation one because that works better for Linux servers. We're going to say this is going to be 2048, so that's 2 gigs of RAM. You can use dynamic memory for this. I'm going to switch that off, otherwise it's going to slow down my machine. Let's push next. Here it's going to say what network do you want to connect it to. I'm going to just choose Untangle WAN here, and I'm going to push next. Create a virtual hard drive. That's where it's going to save it. It's going to be 127 gigs. If you are going to have more than 50 devices, say 500 devices, that virtual size needs to be at least 500 or 600 gigs. How many logs you are going to be storing? If you're going to be storing for 6 months, for a year, then it depends on, you need to sort of like, you need to give yourself extra space to store those logs. Okay, so let's push next. We're going to install an operating system from a Bootable here, and this is going to. Okay, if you go to untangle.com. So we're untangle.com, move your mouse over, get untangle, and say free download. Okay, so now that we're on the Untangle website, it does say that you should probably sign in with them if you have an account, or you could create an account here. If you want to do that now, that's perfect. Right now, we're just going to say skip to downloads. At the time of recording, we're on 14.2.0, and here is the ISO, which I'm going to click on and save it. Here, into the downloads. And let's go to Untangle. And let's push next. And finish. Okay, so now it's going to create the virtual machine. So now that we're on these settings, let's go in here and go into settings. If you've looked at the specs of your machine and how many users you're going to be protecting, you would obviously play with the RAM allocation here. You might even enable the dynamic memory and say, well, I want to go all the way up to 16 gigs or 32 gigs or whatever you want to do. Right now, I'm going to keep it on 2 gigs for this. Under processes, on the table below, you will see that the amount of processes that you require are dependent on how many users you are using. We're going to set up as using 2 processes here. The next thing you'll see over here is we only have 1 network adapter, which is the one that we chose during the setup. So we need a second one. So add hardware, add network adapter, add, and we're going to choose the other one. So right now you see we've got Untangle WAN. We're going to choose Untangle LAN. And we're going to say, okay. So let's double click into this and push start. Great. So choices are graphical install or install. Graphical install is just really prettier. It doesn't really do anything different. So I'm going to push enter on graphical install and wait for it to start up. Pick your language and do English. Your location, I'm in South Africa, so I'm going to choose South Africa. And the keyboard. This isn't what type of language you're doing. So if you do British English, we'll actually do the British layout for your keyboard. Most people have the American English keyboard with the at sign above the number 2. So we're going to choose the American English. Push continue. Okay, so let's wait until this comes up. The next step is going to be asking us what we want to do with our hard drive. Starting up the partitioner, and here it's saying, if you continue, these changes will be listed, will be written to the disks. So we're going to say, yes, we want that to happen. And we're going to say continue. And now we're going to wait, depending on how fast your hardware is, between 5 and 20 minutes. So if you've got to this point and it says here installation is complete, that means it's all installed. So let's push continue and restart. Sometimes it does sort of like hang at this point. Don't worry about it. It is doing stuff in the background. Don't push buttons, don't sit like you're excited, just wait. Okay, so we rebooted. We've now come into the wizard. Let's push continue. Obviously, if you have a different language, please choose your different language. Okay, type in an admin account password here. Anything you want, just make it quite difficult. Under install type, choose the type of install you would like to use. If you are one of these particular companies or higher educations or federal government, it will install certain apps for you and do certain settings for you. I like to do it all from scratch, so I'm going to click on other, and then finally click your time zone. So network cards. It's going to ask you if you want to save your password here. I'm not going to save my password right now. What I would suggest you do here is actually test if your correct network cards are labeled as the correct things. So the ones that we originally set up in Hyper-V, I'm going to unplug my external network card. And let's see, there we go, disconnected. And then I'm going to unplug my internal network card. Fantastic. Okay, plug them back in. It takes sometimes between 30 seconds and 60 seconds to actually come up and sort of like say that it's still connected. So give it a bit of time. Great. So now they both say they're connected. Let's say internet connection next. If all is running well, you will see that your Untangle has found an IP address via DHCP. And if you click test connectivity, it should say success. So let's see. I suggest you do this first before playing with any static and manual settings so that you know that you're actually good. So we're going to choose static here, and we are going to set an IP address for the external part of Untangle. So it's going to be 192.168.0. The root was 0.1, so let's make this 0.2. Okay, it's got a net mask of 24. So there we go. And the default gateway of 0.1. DNS, you can either use your internal DNS server, or I'm just going to use my router here again, and I'm going to push test connectivity again. Theoretically, it should say successful. Fantastic. So push OK, and let's push internal network. It's going to want to save it again. Stop it. Okay. We are going to set this up as a router. So what it does, the internet traffic is going to come from your internal network. It's then going to hit the internal or the LAN network card of Untangle, get processed by Untangle, and then go out the external WAN part of Untangle. So on the router, we need to sort of like have a different IP address. So we're going to say 2.1 here, that's fine. If you've got a setup in your network already and you've got 500 computers or whatever you've got, sometimes it's easier to set your external router and your external card to be another IP range and your internal to be your current IP range. But whatever you need to do, let's do it like this. I'm going to give you more information now. So let's go to router, and we're going to take away DHCP because my router already does DHCP, and in your network, it might actually be done by your Active Directory server or by your router. We're going to do automatically install upgrades because we want to sort of like just set it and forget it. And the second thing is to connect to the command center, because later, once we've finished the whole setup, the connection will allow you or your IT provider to manage your firewall from outside the network, from offsite. I'm going to push finish, and I'm going to push go to dashboard. Okay, So now that we've logged in, what you'll see is your dashboard. Currently says no one is active. So what we're going to need to do is go through your network here, through the Untangle LAN, go into properties, TCP/IP4, and we're going to set our internal network, 192.168.2. Let's say this computer is going to be 2.100, 168.2.1, and 192.168.2.1. Okay, so we're saying go out through Untangle. So all of your computers on this network that are going through Untangle would be on the 2 range, or whatever separate range you're going to be using for your internal network. So push OK, push OK. Let's open up Firefox. Do a search. Okay, so we're on the internet. So if we go and look here, let's just refresh this. There we go. Currently says one active person, which is me. No excitement there. So we now need to sort of like do something and make sure that it blocks porn, for instance. So I'm going to go into apps here and I'm going to say install apps. I'm going to go to web filter, click on it, and then it's going to start installing. Fantastic, it's installed. Let's go back to the apps there and let's go into web filter. Let's make sure that porn is actually blocked. So let's go to categories and let's type in porn. And what you'll notice is that it's under sensitive group, under adult and pornography, blocked and flagged. So theoretically, if I now type in porn.com and push enter, it will not go through. Fantastic. So now basically it says that it did not connect because of a security issue and there's SSL inspectors that need to be done. But right now it says that we cannot get through to porn, but we can get through to everything else because porn is actually blocked. I hope that helps. We're going to carry on with a couple other videos about this, but that is step one of many, many steps. Osh.co.za today is a Gold Untangle partner. Get in contact with us for your 5% discounts on all Untangle software. Please also subscribe for future amazing videos.